Well, here we are, like, track side again. Yeah, a little bit of drama, but nothing to mention to put on YouTube. The CSX, well, I can't blame the railroad itself, but the crew shortages the railroads are all having is starting to affect the St. Lawrence sub. Our crews ain't short. It's the Syracuse Terminal subdivision and the river line in that area that's causing our issues. Because what happened is 2 days ago, this happened while I was at work, a southbound went by at 8 a.m. The next day, at 5 a.m., they couldn't run any trains because that 8 a.m. southbound I went through got to CP 291, which is where the Y is to come up to St. Lawrence. They deadheaded the train there, cut the power off, took the power somewhere else for another train, and it sat there all for like 2 days. So this is the first northbound in 2 days. It's about 150 cars. Leader's a looker. The whole train scares me. I'm surprised he made it around Ridgeline Curve. It's as heavy as it is. You'll see why. You can hear him blowing his horn down there. So he's got the ST-70, I think he's leading it. The 8900 series. Anyway, that's where our ground is right now. Decent sized train today, heavy. Looks like he's got some flat cars, Fort Drum in it. But it's at the, it's the first, like, first, almost at the head of the train. And we're all worried about these huge center beam lumber cars not making around the curve. I'm surprised these cars made around Ridgeline Curve. Well, you'll see the makeup of the train when he gets here. I thought for sure the weight of the train would pull those right off the tracks on the Ridgeline Curve, but anyway, yeah. If I could find that audio clip, I have an audio clip of that dispatcher talking to somebody about the issue. Yeah, southbound went by like at 8 o'clock 2 days ago, and it was still there at 5 a.m. the next morning because they took the power off it to put on another train because of the crew issues. So they couldn't run any trains if they wanted to, as I was blocking the main. Alright, well, tucked away as far as I can off the tracks. This forest here. M620 Lacona, New York. I'm back in the day, you could actually see straight down to the curb down there, but never pointed this out before. Obviously, you got the block station, right? Now, back in the day, this used to be a signal territory back in New York Central days. You can still see the base of a signal mast buried right there. That's where a signal used to be way back in the day. Yeah, this used to be double tracked, I believe, in New York Central days. And now we're lucky to see one train a day. Well, thanks for watching.